St. Louis, adds stability at the second base spot. I need to see a little more offense out of him, though, to crack the top 10. Coming in at number 10 after a very disappointing season is going to be Robinson Cano. Robinson Cano should probably be outside of this top 10, I'll agree, but he was injured last year, so we didn't get to see a full season of him, and when he was finally healthy with the Mets, he was starting RBIs, 256 batting average, which was a career low, 307 on base, 428 slugging, and a 736 OPS, almost all career lows in the percentage departments. That being said, when Robinson Cano was healthy, he was locked in at the plate. The guy can still hit. His mobility is a little bit limited, and it's a terrible contract that the Mets took, but I think for right now, I have to put him at number 10, just knowing the possibilities of what he can do.
Before it gets interesting, we have the Astros versus the Yankees on the American League, and the Mets Nationals in the National League. For the American League, I think it's going to go to the Yankees. They'll be moving on to the World Series in 2019, beating the Astros in 7 games. And in the National League, I've got the New York Mets moving on to the 2019 World Series. Yeah, here come the comments. I know they're coming. But I'm a believer. The World Series champion for 2019, winning in a 6-game series, is going to be the 2019 New York Mets. That's right. I am going out and saying that the Mets are winning the World Series in 2019. I believe in this team. You gotta believe. And sometimes, you just gotta go with your heart. I'm not one of these fans who typically does this. But I'm telling you, if the Mets stay healthy this year, this is going to be the season I finally see a World Series championship. And we're gonna beat the Yankees. That's right, Yankee fans. Yankees continue to look to improve that starting rotation. They go out and grab New York native Patrick Corbin, the second best free agent on the market, Manny Machado. Everyone's wondering, where is he going? Is it New York? Is it Philly? No, he's going to the Atlanta Braves. So let's go ahead and give my predictions now as to who's going to be in the World Series from the National League and American League. In the National League right now, I like the Atlanta Braves. I like their team on paper a lot. I think they're going to keep improving. That bullpen is getting stronger and stronger. The starting rotation is probably going to get better. I'm going to go with the Atlanta Braves in the National League. And in the American League, oh, I hate doing it, but it's the New York Yankees. This is like a nightmare scenario for me for the World Series, but man, I think it's probably going to happen. Those two teams just seem like they're going to be really tough to beat right now. And then as for the winner, oh, I'm going to go with the Braves. This is, again, nightmare scenario. Two teams I hate. The nice thing is that the Mets will be flying under the radar because the pressure is not on us. The pressure is not on us to succeed. The pressure is on the New York Yankees because, like I said, if they don't win the World Series in 2018, that is an absolute failure of a season. There is no excuse as to why the Yankees can't make it to the World Series. I understand the Astros are very good, but the Yankees were one game away and they've already improved their team. So yeah, if the Yankees don't make it to the World Series, in fact, if they don't win it, the season is a complete failure. So Yankee fans, make sure you do get in that comment section below and tell me how wrong I am, or just tell me how stupid I am. Our top five started, I got my boy Big Meat Pete Alonso. What a rookie season Pete Alonso had at first base last year for the New York Mets. He almost didn't start the season with them, but he ended up playing in 161 games last year, 53 homers, 30 doubles and 2 triples to give him 120 RBIs, a 260 batting average with 358 on base, 583 slugging, and 941 OPS. Defensively, he's still not great, but he showed big improvements, and let me tell you, he's one of the best scoopers in the league. The guy doesn't miss anything on the ground. He finished 7th in the MVP voting, won the rookie of the year, was an all-star, home run derby champion. The list goes on and on for Pete Alonso. What a fantastic rookie season. Broke the rookie home run record, formerly held by Aaron Judge. LOL, Yankee fans. Like, Big Meat Pete is just good. He is a beast. He's going to be a beast for a long time. I can't wait to see this guy play with the Mets. I'm very excited. He is a top five first baseman in the league.
Gonna be a hit.
Got him. They got him. They got him. Let's go. It's time to celebrate, boys. Let's go play the music.
Here we go. It's coming. Pop.
Stop it. Get some help.
You sweet little elf. Let's go. Mickey Callaway. He's gone.
Finally. finally, Mickey Callaway, he's gone. Thank you. There is a God. The baseball gods, they're real. Oh, Mickey Callaway, I'm sorry like you lost your job. That's terrible. But oh, as a Met fan, as a New York Met fan, you need to be jumping to joy. You just got Christmas in October. Mickey Mouse is gone. Oh, I'm sad. Man, I'm happy. As a Met fan, I'm happy. I don't know how you couldn't be happy. The Mickey Callaway reign is over. The era is...
Judge on the run, dives, and made a great catch.
1-2. Crossed down the line. If it's... The Yankees have swept the Twins.
This one's... Hold on, are you ready for this? As David Ortiz says so well. The Yankees lose. Popping bottles. Another one for the culture. The Yankees lose. Oh. Holler, he throws two sliders in a row. What is he doing? The guy throws 100. You're going to your weaker pitch? They came in second in the American League. For a team that was supposed to win the World Series, it was World Series or bust this year. It's a failure of a season, and years they haven't even made it to the World Series since 2009. Some fun facts about what's happened in baseball since 2009. The Mets have made one World Series, Yankees haven't made any. The Red Sox have won, what, like two World Series since then? I mean, those are your biggest rivals in your division. I think there's something like this is the only Yankees team to never win a World Series in a decade. Like, wow, 10 years in a row, didn't even make it to the World Series. I'm a Mets fan. We lose, but so do the Yankees apparently the last 10 years, because they have not won a whole lot. All right, this is actually taking a little too long here. Let's go. Like that, there are plenty of fantastic Yankee fans out there, but there are a ton that are incredibly vocal, overly confident, arrogant to say the least. They're the reason why this video gets made. And then the Angels Dodgers, and that's because they ran into the Nationals, who were playing better baseball than anyone at that time. The Yankees team was just not built to win this year. They played fantastic baseball, but they were missing a key part on that team, and that was the starting pitching. Overall, we're excited, we're pumped. The Yankees lose. They're absolutely